by Jesse the Body Ventura.
Well, first of all, I'm going to tell you, Shivani, don't you get out of line with me, because I wrestled. You're the man responsible for Bobby Heenan getting run off the air. So you stay in line with me.
Don't you worry about that, Jesse Ventura.
This ought to be some great wrestling with these two, because mechanically, there may not be two more sound wrestlers in the world. Certainly, they got a plan, but the question is, will the plan work? You can have all the plans in the world, Shivani.
Okay, Jesse the Body Ventura, but I would think just right now, the red flags are starting to mount.
Absolutely. Every man has to have tremendous amount of confidence, but as I said before, there'll be only one winner. Confidence isn't going to win it for you.
Anything can happen here.
Hold it down.
Oh, all right. Oh, listen to the booze.
Hey, I said hold it down.
They don't like you, Jesse. You know, I think, though, Jesse, realistically, fans all around the world, regardless if you are from Australia or Great Britain or USA, certainly the tactic will have to really get your blood boiling.
And why is that?
Because he is arrogant, because he thinks so cool of everyone, Jesse.
Simply because the man wrestles.
Yeah, you can wrestle and you can still
treat the commoners with respect.
Yes. Good to have you with us wherever you are. He's looking our way. I don't think he likes the way you're dressed. I don't think he likes anything about anybody.
I think he may be needing a physical from me before the matchup. I can take this.
Get your hands off my chest, please. When he makes his way over here, you stand in front of him.
Hopefully he won't get over here.
Yeah, I agree with that.
One, two. What a crowd here, though. I can't believe it. Filled the capacity. I told you before, not even Mickey and Goofy could get in, and I made sure they couldn't. They didn't have tickets. Do you have a ticket, Shivani?
No.
Frank.
No, I don't. What are you insinuating?
Well, what are you doing here?
Well, I just wanted to sit beside of you. It was okay. Listen to the fans. They are standing Frank. And cheering. Well, they are really prepared. Yeah.
Well, I got a feeling this match could go a long, long time.
Well, they're in such great condition, Jess, that it's going to have to take a long time.
Besides the condition, Tony, it's the egos involved. I mean, how will each man be able to look himself in the mirror tomorrow? That's a tough pill to swallow.
For those with big egos.
Well, you gotta have a big ego to be a top wrestler. Look at this capacity crowd. Wow. Tremendous arena here. Great to be a part of it.
It really is, Jess. It is a tremendous crowd, and they have been fired up for this match, and they have seen a dandy so far.
I'll tell you, the guy who's going to have a problem here is going to be the referee, because he's going to have a real hard time maintaining some kind of control under these individuals in the ring.
So, confidence runs high, laid it in.
Here's a guy that not only likes to dish out punishment, he can take it to and like it. And he's giving a lesson right now at the basics of wrestling.
Execute well, you're right. And now...
I'm always right, Shivani. Don't ever doubt me.
Well, most of the time.
No, always. Say it, always.
I'm not going to argue with you. Look here.
You know, it seems the referee's is laying back and just letting them go at it.
Well, that's what he's doing, these two men.
You know, there's times that maybe a referee should do that, Tony.
Oh, you'd like that, wouldn't you?
No, I'm just saying, let them settle their differences. Be a little bit lenient. Let the match go on. When you got two tough guys like this, they gotta settle it.
That's exactly what we have. Two tough guys. Right.
And the vicious, oh, look at this.
And Jess, you knew it would be like this.
Absolutely. Now, with these two guys,
taking full advantage of this man is really saying something.
Well, we're seeing some great wrestling right here. Some classic.
He tries to break loose the right against the bar.
I can't see it staying that way for too long.
And that may be a mistake.
What would you know, Shivani? How often did you wrestle?
Absolutely none. What a mouth! Oh, they are really going out!
Look at these guys, blow to blow against each other. Wow.
One.
And shots like that can make me
two. One.
Man,
two.
Oh man.
Not wasting any breath at all. Everything right
four.
On top. Anything
five.
Can happen here.
I'll tell you, this is some hectic pace going on in here. This match could well end up whichever has the most endurance to keep up this kind of pace in the ring.
One.
How do you really go up against a guy like that?
Three.
Well, he needs to out-wrestle this guy.
Four.
Get him down on the mat
five.
And teach him a little wrestling. And I really don't know if he has what it takes. It's going to take a little bit of luck to get the job done.
Well, there's always the first time, as they say, so maybe we'll see it right here.
Well, you know, like they say, Tony, in the NFL, any team can beat any other team on a given Sunday.
Right.
The same holds true in the wrestling ring. Some moves and counter moves in that last exchange, Tony.
Boy, this is a high impact matchup. We have a physical encounter from the opening bell. Both men, you got to give them credit, Jesse. Both men are giving it their all here. Let's not discount the ability. He's as tough as they come, Jesse.
Absolutely, especially in a match of this caliber where it's more fighting than wrestling. You look at him, vicious looking. Remarkable, isn't it?
Not only that, he's a very capable wrestler. He knows the holds. There's a lot of scientific holds as well. He chews
right.
Holds in the field, showing us he is much more than that. He has become a complete wrestler.
He better be a complete wrestler.
And I would agree, win or lose in this match is going to take something away from him. He may learn something here.
And no matter what happens in this wrestling, it all always comes back to basics, Tony. Whoever can execute the basics the best, 9 times out of 10 wins it. And 9 times out of 10, a great wrestler will beat a muscle man.
Exactly. You're right.
Giving a good account of himself.
There's no question about that. Win or lose this match is making a great choice.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do, Tony. Win, lose, or draw, whoever wins this thing, I'm going to interview the winner. When this match is over, I will get an interview with the winner.
All right, Jeff. Do we have time? Let me ask the people that we have time with Jesse do anything he wants to do on this show, Jeff? I guess we do.
He takes a quick look out to the crowd. Now, why don't they applaud? Some great wrestling moves right there.
The NFL, maybe the wrestling fan today has been conditioned not to applaud moves like that.
Maybe.
And it is great wrestling, Jesse. You're right. They should applaud it because it's a great move. This has been a classic wrestling match so far, Jesse.
I've yet to see him break a rule yet.
Well, just hang on here. Things will start going his way.
All right.
Looking out to the crowd and... Who do you think this song is? Yes.
Well, who really knows? You know, both are going to feel each other out a little bit. And like I said, it's going to depend on whether it's wrestling or whether it's brawling.
The fan now clapping.
And you know what? He's one of these kind of wrestlers that gets inspired by the fans. He's a guy that definitely reacts to fanfare. Sometimes that's good, sometimes that's not so good.
Now measuring.
He shouldn't be making that kind of mistake listening to what the crowd's saying.
Could have been a mistake.
That is a mistake. And that could prove to be his undoing this evening, Tony.
Both men, duking it out.
And referee Joey Morales. guys are using classic wrestling holds.
Yeah, that looked like a wrestling hold or two on the outside right
now. No. I'm not saying that, Tony Schiavone. I'm saying that sometimes you have to take chances to win.
Some great clotheslines, some great timing.
Unfortunately, there's nobody going for a pinfall here.
The referee.
This is the time to get nasty.
Yeah.
You can get away with anything right here.
Yeah, the cheat.
Absolutely. It ain't how you play the game, it's whether you win or lose.
One!
That's some good things to remember.
I'll write that one down. See, there's nothing out there that says wrestling about that.
Wait a minute, that was a legal move, Tony Schiavone. Just as that was, they have 5 seconds, then it's illegal. That was classic good wrestling, and look at this.
I don't think there's anyone here that really appreciate that move.
I appreciated it, so there's one.
Well, there's one.
Totally legal. Everything legal right there.
It's a matter maybe here. Look here.
The referee sees nothing. I love it, Tony. I love it. That's called using your hands.
Well,
I can't believe Marilla didn't see that.
You like that?
I love it. He's playing with his hands.
You think he's playing with him, or is he really afraid of it?
Oh, come on, Schiavone. Look at him. He's accomplished everything. Together. He's not afraid of anybody.
Well, I tell you what, Jeff.
He's playing a mind game.
All right. So once again, we got a good strategy for using a good move that, if you didn't time it right, could still give you
a chance. Strategy, Schiavone, is animal instinct. Ain't no different than when you corner a tiger or a gorilla or whatever. They have instinct. They can fight. They don't fight on strategy.
Can't you compromise and say maybe it's a little bit of luck?
I don't compromise.
Oh, Jesse.
Hey, it ain't how you fight the match. It's who wins at the end. The guy doesn't know how to wrestle. Strictly a ball. Very Neanderthal. And changing the tide of that match. And that's the difference right there, Schiavone. You got an instinct wrestler going against a thinking wrestler.
Well, that instinct certainly has led to many victories.
The tide of this match has changed tremendously. You got to see how strong he is. You can't take that kind of punishment.
But that's the point. Still remains to be seen how much punishment he can take. Now, there's your instinct, Jeff, coming through right there.
The animal has resilience, doesn't he?
He really does. I should have said that. He'll think I was calling him an animal also, which is not the case at all. That attire, Jess?
Well, to me, it looks like some of it's missing.
Maybe it's the fashion of the 90s.
Oh, don't say that.
Maybe we'll see you wearing something like that.
I don't think so. I think I'll stick with my Mickey Mouse here. I'll call the play-by-play here, Tony. You look like you need to get your mustache put back on. You're the only guy I know, Tony, that can grow one in a half a second.
Do you like my costume?
Yeah. How'd you like my costume, Tony?
That's only a costume Jesse Ventura could wear, I guess.
And even more importantly than that, Tony's growing his beard and mustache back. Like doing this matchup.
Oh, the beard and mustache are easy. The ball smiling on my head is difficult.
That haircut makes Gene Okerlund's hair look good.
Now, Jesse.
Listen to this capacity crowd coming to their feet almost.
punishment can he take up top?
That used to be my old hold right there. Nobody knows that hold better than me.
You like that, don't you? That's a big smile on your face.
I think I was the first one that ever did that.
The first one?
First one, I think. Look at these two guys Great. Going toe-to-toe.
Just duking it out, these two.
This is turning into boxing.
It really is. He keeps going straight ahead.
Oh, look at that. Cheap shot right to the eyes. Can't beat him wrestling.
Now, you're right this time.
And you know, no matter how big you are, a good poke to the eye will slow you down.
Well, you can question the use of it, but there's no doubt it'll slow you down.
Oh, this is horrible. This is horrible. This is utterly terrible. Now there's no referee to stop this. There's a major problem here. Now, do you consider that fair, Tony?
Well, that just about sums it up.
You think so, Shivani?
Well,
you're pleased with what went on there?
Yes.
Oh. What do you mean, yes, Shivani?
Jesse, we knew it would be a brawl. We knew the tempers would flare in this match, so you gotta expect something like this to happen.
Oh, come on, Shivani, you're grabbing for straws.
Oh, man, Jesse, you can't tell me.
Hey, Shivani, you just called the match. Don't you try to make predictions or tell referees what to do.
Well, no, man.
You know, you're even dumber than Monsoon. I thought Gorilla was the stupidest guy alive. And you notice those are all pros' fists. This is ridiculous that Joey Varela is allowing this to take place. Find a way to condone that, Tony.
Where?
Anytime it happens to your favorites, you sit and yell about it.
Well, I think the special circumstances dictate.
And you call me a politician?
Yeah, you are one.
Oh, yeah, right. Special circumstances dictated. I'll tell you what, though, he's turning into a wily veteran, being able to get away with that.
That's
behind
right.
The referee's back.
Sometimes a man's got to do what a man's got to do.
I just want you to remember that quote, Shivani. Real close in, close fist right there.
Running.
Should be disqualification, Tony.
You know.
I know the rules. He's doing a number on him. It's obvious. Anybody can see that, Shivani.
What? Yes, I really think I
do. You are that blind, are you?
This is proving nothing.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, Shivani. Why is it you won't say when your favorites break rules? Tony?
Well, you say it for me, Jess. Why do I need to be redundant here?
But you're notorious for repeating what I say. You're supposed to be unbiased. I get enough of that from McMahon.
What? Middle of the road here, not part.
Oh, I've heard it all now. I'm going to tell you what you don't want to hear, Tony, but you're getting what he deserves right here.
You're right, Jesse.
And now the shoe's on the other foot.
You're right again.
I'm getting right too often here.
They should get him away from the ropes.
You can use the ropes, Shivani. You never wrestle, you know that.
One.
Another big smile on your face, Jess.
That took the starch out a little bit.
It really did. One thing you can say, and I know you'll agree, he's a man that when he has the advantage, he can really take it right there. And that's exactly what he's doing. Yeah. Not letting him at all.
Saved himself from going down to defeat.
What a hand and eye that was, Jesse. Tremendous move. He had him covered. That was close.
Close but no cigar and back in front.
Why in the world, a question here now, why after that sensational move would he not try to pin a man?
Wrestlers are so used to going for pins. You're so used to in that ring trying for a 1-2-3 count to win a match.
But it didn't happen. We're back to action here.
Made me look bad as a color man, didn't he? You can hear the crowd Things not going too good for Bobby Heenan.
Wow. Yeah, but you got Heenan and you got the Slickster.
They're not wrestlers, they're
amateurs. Exactly. Tell them that sometimes. The Slickster and Jimmy Hart.
Tony, you gotta take your hat off to Jimmy Hart. A little guy like him sacrificing his body. Jimmy Hart does not interfere in a match. All he does is sit outside the ring with the megaphone and coaches his wrestlers, which is exactly what a manager has the right to do.
And I bet you he was a Boy Scout.
You think so? Think he made Eagle Scout?
Little pipsqueak.
Hey, wait a minute, Shawty. With all the weight you've lost lately, how can you call anyone a pipsqueak?
Well, I'm not a pipsqueak.
You ain't exactly Godzilla anymore. The mouth of the South, he's pretty slippery and he's pretty quick.
The Colonel stays behind the ring post when he runs his mouth.
One, two.
Hey, Jimmy Hart's no dummy.
No, he's not a dummy.
Isn't that Jimmy sneaky? Don't you just love him, Tony?
Well, I don't know if I love him or not, but you're right, he is sneaky.
I mean, he gets in and out of there, does his damage so well, referee doesn't see a thing.
He's quick, there's no doubt.
Always remember something, Tony. It's whether you win or lose. It ain't how you play the game.
I'll try to pass that along to my children one day. For goodness sake. We just had some derogatory words about Brutus the Barber you heard in his poem.
Hey, say what you want about the genius. The man is smart. Is a tremendous athlete. He does many great athletic moves. I remember not too long ago on a Saturday night main event, the genius upset Hulk Hogan.
Now, wait a second.
Shivani, who won the match?
Yeah, but Mr. Perfect was on the outside with a belt. We all saw it.
No, yeah, but who won the match? The genius.
The genius won.
All right.
Miss Elizabeth?
She's a little gold digger.
Now, Jesse.
Randy Savage made her what she is today. She was nothing. She was a wrestler down the street of Jersey.
Two.
She is a lady that stands behind her man.
Yeah.
And all the fans of the world know that.
They call them Four Brother Sailors. That's right.
Five. Six. Seven. Eight.
For good measure.
That was totally awesome.
There, that's something that you learn in amateur wrestling. You've got to have a powerful neck to survive in the world of the pros.
It is one of the most painful maneuvers.
And yet it's very simple. It's a very simple hold.
And it's a very... It's a scary move because it's the type of move that can end a career.
Now that's what's dangerous because you can hurt yourself as bad as you can your opponent.
Absorbed a lot of the pressure. These two men have really been in a battle.
defense on his part.
He's hung in there and doing quite well at it also.
Great.
The fans stomping and clapping. Listen to him.
I'll tell you, this is a great, great capacity crowd. Couldn't put another person in here if you tried, Tony.
Not with a shoehorn. Take a look.
Tony, if I can add in, I wrestled Terry Funk to a one-hour draw in Seattle, Washington, 1976.
Wow. Terry Funk had many battles. He and his brother with the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
Well, I heard Dusty Rhodes entered the Mr. America contest one time and won most abs. Most abs, not best abs.
They hear it from Jesse the Body Ventura.
One, two,
we, as Gene Okerlund said, we are having live behind-the-scenes interviews on the Wrestling Hotline. And we will be on the hotline throughout the entire weekend. Make sure you give us a call. Kids, get your parents' permission before you call. And fans, don't forget, we will be on the hotline with the commentary from now. Witnessing what the world is watching.